Hello everyone, welcome to a late night daily runner. At least it's late night for me. It's an Eve run. We haven't played Eve for a while. We know how this works. You try not to get hit so that you can try and use your razor blade to any effect whatsoever. And then you get yourself into the Horror of Babylon state and you steamroll the game. Good job. Please though. This thing. Now Eve starts off... Oh, my throat. My voice is a bit croaky today. Apologies. Also, my fingers are not doing the right things. Maybe we stand here? I know this is doable, but it kind of helps if the, the barrels are configured correctly. It seems to have worked, and we found a secret room as well. Eve's actually quite fast, which I hadn't realised in the past. Retrovision is not too bad. A quarter is a good start too. But she does get faster when you activate Horror of Babylon, but don't forget that she does start off with... a low damage stat, which is easily increased by getting into the Horror of Babylon state, but you don't really want to do that. Until you have something to protect you from the inevitable backlash vis-a-vis, you're going to run out. You're going to want a Spirit Heart. At least one Spirit Heart. We might as well blow up this and see if we get a crawl space. We didn't. And then we'll blow up this and see if we get the small rock or a Spirit Heart. It's a Spirit Heart. Just one, but one is better than zero. Now that we've got that protection, we can think about using the Razor Blade to take away one of our red hearts and thus get into the Horror of Babylon. But compared to E.G. Maggie, I don't actually mind playing as Eve. Her starting damage is actually really, really passable. And finding that I can actually get on quite well with this. And then there is a Curse Room here, which kind of makes me slightly upset that we took a Spirit Heart earlier, but maybe we can get some bombs from our boss or some way into... Oh, yeah, just a bomb from our boss would definitely allow us to get into that curse room for free, because we can use the secret room. I will use this here and try and get... Whoa, careful. There's a bunch of extra damage associated with the fact that you are now in a Horror of Babylon state, but you also get damage from using the razor blade in the first place. It's a damage upgrade for this room. Why am I trying to catch these bullets? That's not how it works. And of course, we've got Dead Bird now floating around doing some damage whenever it decides to aggro, which is basically never, but you understand. There is a second Spirit Heart, so we might as well take this and then spend it on the Curse Room, because I think it's very valuable to get to the Curse Room. And we did pick up Old Bandage, which doesn't really help us because we want to try and get rid of our HP as Eve. Try and make this Horror of Babylon thing permanent. But whilst we've got the Razor Blade to get us into the Horror of Babylon state basically at will, picking up red hearts is not that bad an idea. And now that we've got a decent amount of damage behind us, or in front of us, we don't need to worry too much about how much damage we're going to take over the next few floors, because we're going to be doing more damage and we're going to be, you know, removing enemies in good time, thereby reducing the amount of damage we actually take. The Curse Room was, of course, a bit of a wash. We were probably hoping for something a little bit more valuable than three flies and a couple of spiders, and the spiders were not even friendly spiders. But, you know, you go into the curse rooms on the off chance that you get something great like Guppy's head. Nine lives, that sort of thing. Nine lives would have been great for us because it would have effectively removed any chance of us not being in the Horror of Babylon state. At least until we pick up another HP upgrade. And the HP upgrade that we did collect was one that doesn't actually fill in the HP in the container. It simply gives us the... Why am I going in this way? It simply gives us the HP container to fill up later if we choose to. But as noted, now that we are in said Horror of Babylon state, we're doing enough damage... Ooh, thank you. To not really worry about how much damage we're going to be taking over the course of at least the basement. You know, most of these things die with one hit. And that's going to be good enough. Unfortunately, we have not yet picked up a key. And that's not for want of trying, it's just simply been impossible. There has been no key dropped. And the ability to purchase anything is basically gated by a key. Meaning that we haven't even been able to buy another key. Unless there's a secret room next to the shop. Or I suppose in this case, the item room, because that's really where we're trying to get to. And we get something like... I can see forever pill that will allow us to get through the secret room without any bombs, because obviously we have no bombs either. All that we can really hope for is for some bombs from this boss, Oh, that was really bad. There is a red heart on the ground, which I'm not going to take, because I don't want to turn Horror Babylon. I could take it. This is not... This is the keys, basically. We take Rotten Baby, but we leave Betrayal. I will take enough HP to make using our Spacebar item worthwhile on the next floor. Don't forget, we're doing well enough, and we've got enough damage just base Eve at this stage to think about maybe just, you know, going with literally base damage. Do I want Steven enough? I think no. It's not really worth spending a full heart of damage to step over those spikes to get Steve. You know, Steve is it's an okay item. I don't really mean to say that it is particularly poor. But we have got... more fucking flies. We have got Rotten Baby. Rotten Baby is going to be producing flies on a regular basis whenever we don't have one. Specifically, whenever we don't have one that is produced by Rotten Baby itself, it will create another one. So we now have four flies, which is great. And the flies scale with your damage. So whenever we're in the Horror of Babylon state, we'll be getting much more powerful flies. And therefore, I don't think it's really worth spending a whole... Spirit Heart, which I'd like to blow up that as well, but I can't, obviously. A whole Spirit Heart just to get Steven, which is basically a worse version of Rotten Baby. It fires occasionally. It does have tracking shots. It has homing tears. But I don't really consider that too valuable. We'll use this now. I mean, it does count as... Ooh, I forgot that you did that. It does count as damage. So we are taking damage to do this, but... I think it's okay. It's constructive damage, especially as Eve. Possibly we should have made sure that we're not going to get arcade, but I just realised that this is an odd-numbered floor, so we won't be getting an arcade because we can't. So I think this was the right choice. And the fact that we saved a key... We seem to have got an extra key, actually, because we did purchase a key. Yeah, rune bag is good. Where are we going, by the way? We're going to looks like Isaac. So we don't really need to worry about an AWAS rune, which is great, because knowing me, I will completely forget about the AWAS rune requirement had it been a thing, which it is not. This is almost certainly a secret rune, but of course, no bombs, no secret runes. So this is fine. We've got just enough damage for this floor, and if we can actually pick up an item that we want, that's two item runes with zero items that I've actually cared to pick up. The first one was Key Beggar, and besides the fact that we had no keys then, and I've hardly seen any so far, Key Beggar would just have been an annoyance that would have been like that key there. It would have been stealing our keys as we're trying to, you know, get our key economy even started here. I'm going to try and get rid of this. So with a thing like Key Beggar trying to steal your keys and often succeeding because you can ignore them for a while happily, that was very close. Key Beggar's just a pest, basically. We did get an AWAS rune. We might as well use it. It's not really helping us. We might as well take Little Chad. It's going to give us red hearts occasionally, but... I mean, it's literally only going to give us occasional red hearts. That's fine. Sometime, we may be in dire straits and hoping for some red HP just to keep ourselves alive. It will, of course, interfere with Horror Babylon, but it is what it is. Let's go. That was a very fast floor, so we can leave at any time. And I'm happy with the speed that we're going, although I'm not entirely convinced that we want to be doing Hush on a run like this. I'm not against the idea. We will take Champion Bell. It's a damage upgrade, but we have spent our final key. We can't get into our... We've been into our item room, so we could and possibly should just go. Let's just go. Try and make up some time. Got to get into Boss Rush at least and do it. And I think this is a Boss Rush ready run already, although a Tears upgrade would certainly not go amiss. Let's jump down this one because we can. Now, the AOR's rune could have been better employed getting out of... that's not very funny. Something like a curse room. If we ended up in a curse room as the last... Maybe we do that room? If we ended up in a curse room and then we wanted to leave, we could just use an AOR's rune and get the curse room for half price. Don't take that. But it's not that big a deal, and we kind of just want to go quick and make sure we end up in... Oh, bad trip is bad. Yeah, very good. Thanks. Thanks for the truth. Thanks for the truism. Oh, shit. Here we go. I guess we reroll. Hey, the body. So no more Horror Babylon, but I don't think Horror Babylon's even an option. Why am I permanently firing? Do I have... I do have Mark. Marked. This is bad. I don't like marked at all. But we do have at least Cupid's arrows, so we can... Oh, hell. We can fire through things, which kind of makes marks slightly less bad, because it means we don't have to aim quite as well as we otherwise would have to. Plus, we do seem to have a decent amount of damage here. We have... Charm Tears. Oh, that's Cupid's Arrow, I think, because Charm Tears as well. Otherwise, why would it be called Cupid's Arrow, right? More options is nice. But we're going to reroll it anyway. So we're going to want to reroll this ASAP, basically. But that's why we take the D100, because mad lulz. Also, what was this? We did take it. Did we take it? Excuse me. What the heck? Leave me alone. That's kind of interesting. Well... I don't think we even have Horror of Babylon anymore, so we can't reroll. We can't take away our HP to get into it. Unless it is strictly Eve permanently. I mean, I don't know whether Eve always has Horror of Babylon. Let's not walk on that. I'm going to try and preserve this spirit heart if possible. Of course, I've got Curse of the fucking Lost. Help. What was that? How is that successful? Don't talk about it. Don't draw attention to it. It might run away. Okay, we'll go into the arcade, I suppose. I want to preserve this Eternal Heart, but... do I want to preserve the Eternal Heart at the cost of not being able to play that Demon Judgment, which could be extremely valuable for us, because if it produces any item at all, the item has a strong chance of working towards a transformation like Spun. Wow, careful. And if not that... just the item itself could be super useful because it's going to be a devil item. For example, I think it's a devil item. Although now I think about it, I'm not sure syringes are devil items, and it does tend to pay out with syringes, so... Man, I wish I could stop firing. Please. Answers, of course, is our current rune. It does us no good. It looks like we picked up at least... Well, it looks like we rolled into at least one item that gives us bombs. So we can, ooh, looks like it was Mr. Mega. So we can take these coins, and we can also do this, well, we can't get into the boss trap room now, that's really annoying. So, I guess we do the boss, I guess we go and fight the boss. Man, where the hell is it though? This is a secret room? Yeah. I guess we fight the boss and hope for the best. Because you can't stop firing, you can't avoid... Ooh, that's actually really good. So let's knock this over here without getting hit by these fires. Because you can't stop firing, you can't avoid shooting these TNT thingies. Wow, that's a lot of stuff right there. Right there! Cool. And a trinket. Sure, why not? This is a wooden nickel. I'm not remotely concerned by that. And we will go and see what this joker in here gives us before we do anything else. We don't really have a choice but to fight the boss, but we might as well give this thing as much HP as we care to, because we've used our... Oh, well, didn't mean to do that, because it disappeared at a very unfortunate time. We've used up our Eternal Heart, which has matured into a full red heart, so we can do this as much as we like. Possibly not too much, though, because, of course, we would like to not die against the boss. I really wish I could stop firing because it's annoying me as much as it's annoying you. Right, let's get up here. Stop dithering around. Stop wasting time. Of course it's a stain. I could have told you it was going to be the stain. Then again, at least we can not think about aiming. It looks like we have a halo of flies as well, which there's only two flies when you picked up the item, but nevertheless. Please, though. Change whether I do anything at all. Such a bad item. That was a really easy stain fight, to be fair. We'll use this. It's an HP upgrade, and we'll re-roll into Beelzebub, so we can now fly, but I'm not going to go back and get anything. I don't really care. We have Pyro as well, which is really good. Pyromaniac. We have Pyromaniac. We have 22 bombs. We seem to have 20-20, which is very nice. Tech Point 5, also very nice. Little Gertie is pretty sweet. That was a lucky guess. I do not like scatter bombs, and I will forget, but actually it doesn't matter, because, we have Pyromaniac. It doesn't matter if we to get hit by an explodey bomb. At some point, we will discover whether we still have Horror of Babylon, but I suspect we don't. We also have Gnawed Leaf, which is pretty nice because it means we can just stop moving and be invincible as a result. And we have Eden's Blessing, which is a tiers upgrade, but doesn't really do anything for us on our next run because our next run will be a daily run. It doesn't count, basically. You things cannot hurt me. Well, you can walk into me, I suppose. In fact, you can heal me, which is very nice, thank you. So here's an interesting conundrum. Do we reroll this run or not? Because all the enemies have basically no power against us, provided we just use our bombs wisely, which is almost impossible not to do, because any bomb is going to accidentally hit me anyway, because I'm going to fuck it up. Yeah, let's reroll our stats. Why don't we just reroll fucking everything today? How's that look? Our rate of fire seems to have gone down, and our damage seems to have gone down, but it's only a four-room charge. We can't go in there. Use the Answers rune. Oh, there's nothing except for this very tiny floor, so I'm not going to spend too much effort on looking around. We know where we're going, and that there's nothing else to see, thanks to the Answers rune. We don't have rune bag anymore, so we're not getting any more runes, but I think it's kind of fun to reroll occasionally. I really like this run that we've re-rolled ourselves into. And honestly, I think I keep it. I don't know. It could be so much better, but it could be so much worse. Hello. For some reason I'm min-maxing on bombs right now, but whatever. Actually, because we have tech point 5, our damage is great. You know, these fire, just look how fast the fires fall apart, and that shows you how often you're hitting something. So it doesn't really matter necessarily what your damage is at this stage. We've got such a good DPS. And having 2020, I mean, 2020 is one of those items. Oh, that was really fun. One of those items where you consider stopping your reroll because, oh, and fucking, this is really good. We don't need any of our HP, really, so we might as well get Little Brimstone. We might as well take the Book of Sin as well and see what it gives us. It gives us a Spirit Heart, so that's actually also pretty good, let's be honest. And I'm just going to leave. I know we can't get into the shop, and we could buy something cool. I know we could keep re-rolling with the D100, but I'd like to win. And I'd like to also get to Boss Rush, and if we keep faffing around with the D100, we'll never make it to Boss Rush. What the hell am I supposed to do with that room, huh? I guess you're supposed to go a bit faster. So we left there behind the D8, which was rerolling our stats. We left behind the D100, which was rerolling all our items and all the items, I mean, on the ground. We're quite slow, so any upgrades right now would be very valuable to us. But, I mean, there's not so many rooms left. There's not so many items left in the game until at least the chest. Can't get in there because we have too much HP, which is a shame. But look, we've got all these flies. Oh, we've got a Little Brimstone as well. Don't forget you picked that up. Okay. Sun card. So we'll use this on a room as a death card and tell us where we're going. Very nice indeed. We can get into the curse room for free, which is also valuable. Some more money. Don't mind. We know where the item room is, so we don't have to worry about not getting to Boss Rush. And I'm going to be very blasé about explosions, which is probably one very good reason to stop rerolling.
Judgment.
Yeah, we'll give some money to the Judgment. I mean, we're not aiming for Horror of Babylon. And, oh, okay. Blue map is also pretty cool. We can't fly out for free. Yeah, we're not aiming at Horror of Babylon anymore. I don't think we have Horror of Babylon anymore, although I haven't tested this theory. All right, we haven't done this one. Done this room. So, ooh, that's nice. I guess it doesn't matter. What I'm saying is, because we're not aiming at Horror of Babylon, it doesn't matter how much HP we have, so if you want to give something that's likely to give us HP, the money required to do so, vis-a-vis the judgment there, the coin judgment, we should do. I kept my Wheel of Fortune card because I think we're going to the chest. And on a chest run, if you explode the Wheel of Fortune card, you're guaranteed to get an item out of it. That's very nice too. We have 66 cents. Arcade gives us... Wait, an arcade on two floors in a row? Or did I do a whole floor and forget? I think I may have done a whole floor. HP is also fine. I've got two things to charge up, and it's nice having several things that charge up at once. Little Gertie isn't really that great, but where are all these flies coming from, by the way? Horror Babylon? No. Little Brimstone is pretty sweet. We're going to the shop because we have enough money to make it worth it. That's probably worthwhile just from a daily standpoint, and I will buy this just because why not, right? Now we've got plenty of HP. No, we don't need to worry at all about how we're going along. We've got the Book of Sin, which is not that great an item, but it's probably better than the D8, which is liable to cause me much grief by accidentally re-rolling my stats into utter bullshit at some point. We have the ability to heal ourselves for free as a result of... Ooh. Hello? There you are. That was a bit of a misplay, I didn't mean to pick that up. We can heal ourselves for free as a result of the fact we have Pyromaniac, which means every explosion heals us. Range down is, sucky but not terrible. And of course plenty of bombs, and all those bombs are scatter bombs, so they have themselves stars card. Where are we? Let's see what I really need that. What was I saying? Yes, we basically cannot die because of Pyromaniac. And all the bombs have multiple bombs, so each bomb can heal us multiple times if we get into the situation where we need to do that. And honestly, I don't think we do. We have an orbital, which is great for if our, you know, tears are not good enough. It does a lot of damage. We have... Oh, we're going down to the dark room. Very well. This is an excellent selection. Now, the soul gives us benefit in Hush to some extent. But I think, by and large, our best item here is this one, Toxic Shock. And the reason I say that is that apart from the Hush fight, which is very long, and this room as well, most rooms are going to suffer greatly from Toxic Shock, and our damage is not that great. Ooh, hello. We do have Little Brimstone backing us up. Very much appreciate Little Brimstone backing us up. And apparently that was a champion mom, because this is a champion boss rush. And I hate this thing for being so accurate with its... spider chucking. But it is dead. Plenty of spirit hearts showing up, so I'm wondering whether we have something that's producing them that's not showing up. We also have Ouija boards, so we can shoot across rocks, and I haven't noticed that until just now. But it certainly means that with the ability to fly, which we got from re-rolling so much, we can just sort of spawn camp over rocks and all that sort of shit. Really scum up this game and make sure that we have the best chance ever of not dying. We picked up a black heart. Thank you for the black heart. Don't know what gave us that, but I appreciate it nevertheless. Because our actual tier damage is not that great. But we have double tier damage. We have two at once. You can't jump over me. Oh. And we have Little Brimstone, which I think is just a straight damage dealer. It doesn't have any... doesn't scale with our tiers. Where are you going? I'm fucking going to... We appear to have Friendly Fly? Friendly Zone? Friend Zone. We also have... Papa Fly, the turret follower. It follows you around in the movements that you just made and shoots very rarely and does fuck all damage, but it's nice to have, I suppose. The Little Brimstone is the star of the show here, I think. Our own damage is mediocre, although not horrendous, which is strange. We have occasional flies, but not very often. Little Gertie is doing some damage, but again, kind of hard to hit. And Little Brimstone is just impossible to miss half the time. With, I should say. Very difficult to miss with. Now this, this horsey is going to hit me occasionally if I'm not very careful. There you are. I'd like a Little Brimstone to deal with it, but I didn't need him to. Our actual damage is not terrible. You know, don't let me say that we're in a bad way. Hush may take some time. So may Boss Rush, actually. With all these champion, champion bosses in Boss Rush, we may have a little bit of trouble making it to Hush, simply because of how far we have to go in order to get there. I mean, our damage is not miserable, but it's not stupendous either, so. We've got a long way to go, and all the enemies seem to have a little bit extra HP, so we might get out here in 25-26 minutes. That does not give us long to do both wounds. Although having little brimstone at this point means we can certainly get rid of this Joker without too much effort. Wouldn't mind piercing shots as well. I guess we'll see what we get out of it at the end. Don't forget we did pick up Toxic Shock to start all this off, so it's entirely possible that simply having done that is sufficient to get through many of the rooms that we're going to face between here and Hush, just because they'll take so much damage from Toxic Shock itself. It's a very nice damage dealer at the start of a room, and if the room's full of weak enemies instead of having one or two strong ones, we can also probably try and use this cube of meat. I don't think I can, because we don't really have any reliable way of keeping ourselves alive. We don't want to walk too close to enemies, basically. We're not that strong. I want to make sure I get rid of this one. It's not doing the brimstone bullshit. It's just this one. Oh, that was pretty easy, actually. Little Gertie. Nope, little brimstone did quite a number on that. I don't know if there's a champion version of that, so maybe it was just normal version. Peep here with both his eyes straight up. Not a fan of that. If these two enemies could kill one another, that would be super good. Watch out for the eyes, they are on their way. Try and keep him on the other side of the rocks, that's what I'm doing here. And he's dead, perfect. Let me go and find the other Joker. Where are you? What happened to that just now? Hello? These things on these rooms, though. When they teleport and you can't find them. Fuck, you know. Just fire a little brimstone and hope for the best, right? We're still barely done. I don't know how many waves we've done, but it's not many. It's really not many. Certainly not as many as I'd like it to be at this stage. Champion Gertie, though, can just sit there as far as I can. I'm honestly surprised that that was not a champion angel vis-a-vis the ones you get from Mega Stamp. Something in my mouth. What's going on? And that's a great enemy to use Cube of Meat against. What have we got here? Joker. Pretty nice. We can get a deal with the devil at the end of this, but I do want to finish Boss Rush, because you don't get any points if you don't. We won't be allowed back in, though, so we won't be able to keep our Wheel of Fortune card, which is a minor shame, but we're actually going to the Dark Room rather than the chest, so we're not actually guaranteed an item out of Wheel of Fortune anyway, so I guess who cares. What's the other one? I will use a bomb on this joke. Don't forget we have butt bombs, actually. That's going to do a lot of damage just to enemies. It's basically Toxic Shock whenever we like. And the bombs can't hurt us, so if we can get number two or something like that, that'd be out of this world. You know, we couldn't hurt ourselves with... Ooh, careful. Number two at all. Oh, apparently you can hurt me with that fart. Whatever. But we can definitely hurt the enemies. Oh god, double fucking gate over here. Cage. Take that, thank you. I mean, this enemy should be fairly easy. We just roast it from across the screen. But it's the cages I'm worried about now. They don't seem to have that much less health. Oh, of course those things can't hurt us either, so whatever. Than just one of them, and yet there's two of them. Pardon me. That was really bad. Don't walk into it again. Their bouncing patterns, which is not something I often get the opportunity to say, are a bit weird. Still going, apparently. These don't look like champions. I'm not going to take this pill, and the reason is, if it's the telepills, we A, don't get to finish Boss Rush, and B, don't get to get our Joker card back, because we can't get back into Boss Rush, so I guess I'm going to avoid taking any pills I don't know right now. Makes sense, I think. I'll get rid of this Joker first, shall I? Because he seems to be the most dangerous, because he has that brimstone attack. And I'm wondering if the brimstone attack can actually hurt the other boss. Oh, well, they can hurt each other. So they both have rubbish brimstone attacks. Of course, the reason I was leaving the bony alive was to prevent this one from doing its rubbish brimstone attack. We've got Game Kid. Ugh. The tower. Joker, go.
Joker.
That's pretty nice. We have one orbital that we are using, so we might as well have the other one as well. An other one, not the other one. As if to say there is only one other orbital, there isn't. There are many, but Sack Dagger is super strong. It kind of makes up for a lot of our tier problems right now. Well, we're on our way. We've got 2 minutes. I really don't think we're going to be making Hush. Which is a shame, because I think that we could get through it eventually with perseverance and, you know, everyone tuning out halfway through because what the fuck, how can it take this long? I'm kind of glad, but at the same time, it does lose us quite a lot of points. Tend to go with the Northern Line idea that if you just go through the secret room, you're going to get further in the map than you would have if you haven't. Tends to pay off. Sometimes the secret room is in a really strange location. And sometimes it's not, but it's a good enough sort of shortcut. Seems like a bad thing, unless it's got a decent item in here, which inevitably Cursed the Tower, which is actually good for us now, I think about it. So I wouldn't mind Cursed the Tower. Toxic Shock also leaves a small amount of creep on the ground whenever an enemy dies, so that's also pretty nice. This is not a secret room, even though it looks like it should be. That was risky. Nope. Okay, so going through the secret room didn't really gain us anything. We're definitely not making Hush, because it's gone past the 29-minute mark, and we're not even on the next floor yet, so never mind that. Kind of happy. I do not like fighting Hush, but kind of sad, because being able to fight Hush is, you know, gets you on the leaderboard. I feel like maybe if we D100'd more, or just not done it at all, we would be better off. And if I could stop taking damage, that would also be super nice. I mean, we can't die, but there's also no point in just relentlessly walking into enemies. Like, you have no control over the game that you're playing, which is patently false, because the whole point of playing the game is to sort of pit myself against it in my ability to control it, you know? My ability to control the game is the actual challenge in the game. Ooh, I just whacked the mic. I also know exactly where the secret rooms are, so I don't know why the hell I was looking for them in the first place. He's okay. Doesn't really help us. We're not going to the chest. Or Hush, for that matter. So all the places where we would normally use a key are not applicable. N/A. I do like having Little Brimstone for this fight, because Little Brimstone basically guarantees that you'll be able to hit the bit that sticks out whilst it's sticking out. And, oh, I nearly died. Super Bandage, sure. It's more HP. There's a Guppy item. I think we keep the Guppy item. Book of Sin has been okay for us. It's been giving us some decent items. Couple of HP along the way, but that's fine too. But Guppy's Head is going to be a consistent damage dealer, which is really what we're struggling with right now. We don't have the greatest amount of damage, and every single room we get a few more flies, and of course we are Beelzebub, Lord of said flies. And if we can get another Guppy item, we've probably had at least one. There's a small chance that we get Guppy, is what I'm saying. If we can get Guppy, we're basically sold. I don't really need that, but I will go to the secret room. I'd like to go to the boss trap room, but I suspect I cannot. Yeah, I'll give you some keys. I'm not going to use them myself. Red chest, Guppy. Spirit Heart is fine. Probably not worth the keys I paid for it. Guppy? Troll Bomb. I think that's enough for you. You've had enough. I'm cutting you off. Can't get into that room. I was correct. This room's pretty good when you've got orbitals and a laser. Not that the orbitals are doing anything good. Notice that the orbitals are actually at 2/3 rather than halfway around the thingy, because we've got one fly, which isn't an offensive orbital, but it is a defensive orbital. Why so many red chests? Good question, I hear you ask. I hear you crying. Why so many flies, actually? Maybe we have the... I'm going to guess we have car battery, and it's not showing up because it doesn't fit on the screen. That's the only reason I can think of that Guppy's Head would be giving us this many flies consistently. We'll find out what it was. It was a health up. Well, could have taken that in boss rush, but chose not to. Probably for the best. Again, it could have been the telepills and ruined our boss rush pointage. quite important. I don't know why I'm running away from these bombs. Oh well, let's see if the boss is over here and then leave. I hope it is over here, because I'd like to leave. Yes. I'd also like this room not to be here. It's a bit of a bugger. Ah, it's fine. Lemon Party is a fine pill, but we will possibly perforate something. Maybe on the dark room, maybe on a deal with the devil. How did you get hit there, please? Try and use the orbital as much as possible here. It does involve getting in close in a very scary manner. But... oh, you dick. Help! Very close and nice game. We're going down. Maybe we could have perthrowed Super Bandage. I don't really feel like it's that big of a deal. We're never going to get back into Horror Babylon, even if we do still have it. So, having the extra HP to survivability is, I think, is more worth it. And we still have the perthrow rune now for any time we have several items on the chest. We probably should have perthrowed the Book of Sin, maybe. And it would have perthrowed into something else. Well, there we go. Something else boss rushy? Nope. Something else devil dealy? Possibly. I'm not quite sure how that works. I believe if you are still in the deal with the devil, when you perthrow, you get a deal with the devil item. Even if it's on a pedestal. Like, even if you bought it and it's just an item in the room, if you re-roll it, it re-rolls into a devil item, I believe. It's a good way of getting a free amazing devil item, but I guess we've already missed that boat. Here's our boss, but I think maybe we explore a bit more. I'd like to know where we're going, but it's not telling us. Yeah, try it. Please. Anyway, land. Good. We will open all of these because we have Mom's key and there's no reason not to. I see a Chobon. I do. Plenty of flies. That's really helpful. And retrovision is not. Well, that's everything in that room. We might as well fight the boss, even if we don't want to go down immediately. Well, at least we got the scatter bombs damage. I would have rather got the main bombs damage. That was very good timing by my orbital there to protect me from myself. Which is to say, my inability to dodge a fucking bullet. Just dodge. Honestly, there comes a point where you realize that rather than dodging the bullet, you simply need to move with some knowledge about how the bullet's traveling. I mean, if you've got five bullets coming towards you, one of them is aimed at you, so you move a small amount that doesn't quite move enough to walk into the other bullet. Rather than trying to dodge between the bullets and see where the bullets are, you just sort of make a judgment call as to how far apart they are. And don't move that far. Oh, you can't hurt me unless you walk into me, of course. I don't think the feet can hurt me either, now I think about it. Because I think they're explosive damage. Let's use an orbital. That gets it done much faster. Very happy to have done so. I'm too lazy. We can get way more points by exploring the rest of this floor. I'm just not going to. So, fuck it. We are in the dark room. We have a perthrow rune. We can re-roll something. Did we take 9 lives? I think we take 9 lives. Guppy? No, there's one more Guppy to come. It's possible there is still an opportunity for Guppy to be available in this run. All we need is a red chest. I don't know, if we re-roll it, I don't think it re-rolls into another Guppy, like another red chest item. I think it just re-rolls into a dark room item, which is all good. It's the item pool, the item room item pool. As far as I know, it could be the everything item pool. As far as I know, I mean, I genuinely don't know what you can get out of these chests. But I'm pretty sure that if you reroll a guppy item, if you reroll a not guppy item that comes out of a red chest, you do not get another red chest item. But I think still you get red chest items from a red chest if you're gonna. If you get items from both gold chests and grey chests. Like, iron chests, I guess. course, 9 lives has given us way less HP than we had before, to the extent that we now can't actually use our Pyromaniac to heal ourselves, because we cannot lose enough HP to have any red heart container gaps to fill up with Pyromaniac. Item. The Loki is okay-ish, I guess. I think we should use the, no, this is very min-maxy, what I'm about to say. And it kind of goes against my religion, but I think we should use Guppy's head at the start of the room instead of the end. That way, if the room sucks and we don't want to waste flies, we get to save the use of Guppy's head until the just before everything dies. And then we still get two... help. Still get two uses out of it. Help. This death is just not dying, ironically. And then still this fucking second one as well. But, I mean, it's so min-maxy, you know. It's maybe six extra flies, which could really make a difference now I think about it. We do have 9 lives, but if I could stop getting hit by this fucking joker, that would be swell. I might have to just use my, sorry, hello? Oh, the horse is still alive. I might have to use my, my Nord leaf and just stop moving and let my orbital do it until we can get some more HP, because this is actually turning out to be extremely difficult. Right now, I can't have, like, there's no way I can avoid damage on this room. It's gonna hit me, it's gonna hit me. It is what it is. It's random damage. You literally can't avoid it. It's gonna hit you. We're very much like spirit hearts. God, why so many famines? Ah! Fuck! Right. I think I've thrown this, and the reason I've thrown it is that that death fight was really hard, and apparently I'm incapable of just avoiding shots. Oh, you're a poly. Polycephalus, not a snake. That's why you weren't doing that bullshit attack that I hate. Look, anything you want to give me to help out here, game, would be very well received. A chest? No? With a cool item in it? A spirit heart? A health up? Just a pill? A health up pill? I know there is one, I've seen it. Maybe we shouldn't have taken 9 lives. Could have re-rolled it into something that was going to be actually useful for us. Maybe we shouldn't have stopped re-rolling with the D100, because this is an okay run, but it's not that great. Oh, you fucking beauty. That's exactly what I wanted. Oh, it's Christmas. Christmas has come early. Re-roll this. Ugh. It's shit, but it's better. Look, I could have re-rolled anything, but I re-rolled Isaac's Heart, which I think is the only item that is guaranteed a re-roll. Like, in all situations. Help. Literally don't know what's happening right now. Why are they all reflecting? Why are they all turning around? I don't know what was going on. That was very scary, and it was very difficult to deal with, but deal with it I did, so we move on. These enemies I dislike the most, because it's very difficult to dodge if you don't know that a shot is heading towards you. Most enemies aim at you. These ones shoot orthogonally, so if you're not orthogonal with them, you don't know whether to dodge or not. Like, you can't use your instinct to move slightly. As I was saying before, you can't just say, oh, that shot's coming towards me, it's in the middle, so I move between shots. You know, you gotta move just enough. Enough. Oh, fuck. These dark ones. They corralled me, they cornered me. Bastards. I was kind of hoping to get that one to Brimstone down, but he didn't. These ones are easy. You just stand there with Sack Dagger. Avoid that. Sack Dagger. Excuse me. I was Sack Daggering. This is also shit. We can't re-roll it, so whatever. How to jump. We don't need to know how to jump. Bruh. Let's open this. Hematemesis is no good. PhD gives us a pill. The pill is health up. Health up. Infested.
Infested.
There's no value. Well, I strongly doubt that we're going to win this, and the reason is that I've thrown. I threw on that death battle with the two deaths in the L-shaped room, and as a result, I find it very unlikely that we'll succeed in the lamb fight because we just aren't doing enough damage. So it's not going to go down very fast. At some point, it picked up some... yes. We will take the tick. And interestingly, the matchstick is the only thing that will remove the tick, so if you want it to leave again... Oh, you can't kill me. Ha 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 ha. Fuck you. That was very scary because there was no way out of that except to tank the damage, but apparently we don't need to worry about that. Please explode one another. Please find it in your hearts to kill one another with your bullshit troll bomb nonsense. Yeah, try it. Hey, you blowed yourself up, didn't you, you little joker? Incidentally, we do not have Horror of Babylon right now, so we definitely re-rolled out of that. Here we go then, let's try it. I'm very tempted to use my orbitals here, but I'm probably going to avoid doing so. How did we survive this? Can we just get it into the second state? Oh, those weren't hurt. Yes, fucking have it. Pyromaniac, I'm very glad that we kept it. Because any other run that we'd re-rolled into with the D100 could have been just like this. Oh, you fucking tosser. Right? It could have had just as poor damage. Could have been just a bad situation. Just as bad a situation. Except, we wouldn't have Pyromaniac anymore because we would have rolled out of it. Don't get trapped by it. Sorry, what? What hit me then? Come on now. Okay, he just locomoted into me. That's fine too. We can do this. We've got plenty of lives. We've got Sack Fucking Dagger, which is the be-all end-all of orbitals right now. We have Lil Brimstone, who's doing a lot of damage, even still. What? How did they not hit me? And also, what the fuck are you doing? Leave me the fuck alone, you bastard. I want Lil Brimstone to be closer to me so that I can figure out where the fuck he is in order to fire with him. One of these has to die. Either phase, either part just needs to die right now. Please, stop. Either half, just fuck off. Nah, what's happening? Preferably the flying around and hurting me phase. Ah! Shit the bed. Leave me alone. It's dead. I'm just going to be quiet for a while. Trying to remember how the hell to play this game. We're nearly there, though. We're nearly fucking there. Oh, no, you don't. Alright, Sack Dagger. Get in there. Oh, you dick! We did it! We won! It counts! In your face, game! I fucking scummed the shit out of you. 789th, look, we played badly. We missed boss... No, Hush. We missed Hush. We took so much damage on this last floor, we lost five of our nine lives, which we shouldn't have taken. We didn't even get Guppy, but we survived. We survived, and our score and our time rankings are very close together. So thank you for watching. I do hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you will join me next time. But until then, good eye.